Well,
you realize that it was inevitable.
It happened, and it will probably happen 10 more times during this panel.
Hi, Misha.
Hello, Jensen. How are you?
I'm doing well. How are you?
I did an impression of you earlier.
Did you?
It kind of tanked.
Did it?
Yeah, it wasn't that good.
They didn't think it was funny?
Didn't have legs. Yeah, what, that's it.
Now,
no, what?
Like, just roughly speaking, what did the impression look like?
It was,
bicycle toy?
Let me guess.
Okay.
Kind of, like, macho, right? Like, kind of just, like, tough, kind of badass,
yes.
Is my guess?
Well, it was certainly like a sport involved.
Like...
if you want to call it that. Wait a minute. There are people that call it a sport. There are people that refer to it as a sport.
Is it like something like a tough sport, like a kind of like a manly sport?
Yeah.
Is that sport bicycle touring?
I'm not familiar with that sport. What is Yes, it's
like sport.
It's very similar to sport.
Yeah. How, by the way, sore at all?
Sore?
What?
Am I sore?
Sore.
Well, after my panel with Jerry, yeah. I'm sorry, you were talking about the bike riding.
No, I was talking about what just happened.
But with the seat and everything as it is, both the panel and the bike heard me in the same place.
You heard it here first, folks.
Hold on.
Just a minute.
I'm just gonna fill them in for like 10 minutes. And just a little bit.
Stay tuned for these messages from our sponsors.
I can just tell him on the mic. There was a question that had a little bit of innuendo in it. Where I don't know if you know this, but in Italy, they call cum influence. Anyway, it's a long story.
Who's your biggest influence?
Whatever. No, not gonna go. Long story short, the question sort of implied that Cass was the bottom in the relationship. It got pretty graphic.
So there's like, it's like in football, you have your offensive line,
yep.
You have your like tailbacks, you have a quarterback,
yep.
You have a receiver.
Or the center.
I get it. There's also a tight end.
I hate sports analogies.
I don't know that sport. That's American football.
We should take questions.
Yeah, let's take some questions.
Hi, lovely. No.
Okay, now
there you go.
Hello, guys.
Hi.
This is a serious question. I'm Italian, and it is not.
Is that gonna be our code word for question about sex?
It is for both of you.
Okay. Okay. So we should probably establish the same word this question. Mine is keep going.
Okay, we all know you from what we have seen and seen screens and at conventions. But I was wondering if you could tell us a unique story that belongs just to the real
Jensen. Why are you yelling at us? You're so loud. Okay, go ahead.
I'm a little bit nervous, I'm sorry. Okay, if you could tell us just a unique story
yes.
that belongs just to the real Jensen and the real Misha
yes.
that you have never told to anyone, in order to let us know a little bit better. Know you a little bit better.
We have to dust off some of those stories that we usually try not to tell other people.
Fuck. I kind of feel like those stories happen. They get told naturally, like through it's trying a, to, it just, it kind of, I can't just, I don't, it's like, oh.
Yeah, let me tell you the story that we've never told anyone.
Well, there you go, here's a real gem. I don't have that, I'm not, we're not Richard and Rob, we can't.
Okay, I figure it, so.
Well, I guess we could do a Richard and Rob.
Maybe, which is the most weird question that a fan ever asked you.
The last question that we got.
Yeah. The previous question was, I think it started with, this is a serious question.
I'm still racking my brain. I'm trying to think of.
You're actually trying to think of like some crazy story right now.
Maybe just an ordinary story.
Or just a generic story?
Yeah.
Just
there once was.
What's
Father's
Eye? A man from Nantucket.
Many, many moons ago, when we were just boys, my name is Mark Shepard.
Hello, how are you?
I told you this, right? I told them that when I read the script, I read it aloud.
Yeah.
And then Mark's Crowley's lines are read in a very Monty Python esque.
We should make him do that on the show.
Well, he does. That's how I hear it. And I, you know what? I actually have a voice for you.
What is that voice? Never mind. I actually asked that of honest, open curiosity, and then the minute the question came out of my mouth, I was like, that's gonna make fun of me.
I'm gonna find a script. You tell a story that okay. dust off an old story for
No. I will share this with you. This is a sort of a generalization about our private interactions.
Okay.
And I...
Your private
interactions. I've shared this before, so... I think this should... Yeah. We spent a lot of time in Cliff's car. Driving from our trailers to set, back again. And we have often remarked on how... We have a lot of, like, it's our time to sort of have deep conversations, talk about issues that are important to us, and we've often commented on the fact that any randomly selected 15-second portion of that conversation would ruin all of our careers forever if it went public. We make a lot of very dirty jokes, say a lot of things that shouldn't be said by human beings. We laugh. We think it's funny. You're having a hard time finding a script that has Castiel in it, aren't you?
I am. Hey, how about this? How about this? What's an episode this season? Think of a scene this season between Dean and Castiel. Mm-hmm. What is it?
When you're sick.
On the phone. On the phone, baby?
Oh, yeah.
Baby.
Gotcha. That was 11:04. 11:04. Hold on. Blue revisions.
Yeah, make sure you get the blue revisions. I don't want to do the production draft. That's going to cost you a lot of money.
No, it's not. You know what? I have a grandfather clause plan on my phone.
What?
Yes.
And I am going to tweet to AT&T right now.
Do it.
And tell them.
Because Jared, when we were in London 2 weeks ago, Jared's like, hey, dude, you might want to call your carrier and make sure that you've got an international plan. Because you're going to get dinged on the data and the texts and the voicemail and stuff. And I was like, I think I'm covered, but you're making me nervous. So I'm going to go ahead and call. So I called with him sitting right next to me, and I called.
That must have made him so mad.
And I just put on speaker. I'm like, hey, it was like, hi, you know, hi, this is Jeffrey from AT&T. How can I help you? He's like, hey, so I just wanted to know if I'm in England right now. I need to put an international plan. I'm going to be in Rome in 2 weeks. I just want to make sure that, you know, everything's copacetic. And he was like, actually, you're good worldwide. You have a grandfather plan.
That must have made Jared so angry.
He was irate. He was so angry. And I just went like this. I was like, oh, thanks, Jeff.
Thanks, Jeff. Jared recently had an argument with AT&T that sort of took over.
Oh, they know.
Took over the internet, and it also... It wound up with, like, the office of the president of AT&T reaching out to Jared to make sure that they had satisfied all of his concerns. And everybody in the cast and crew spent about 3 days talking to Jared about his AT&T plan. Like, it was serious business around the set. So Jared probably lost 3 days of sleep over that phone call that Jensen had.
Yeah, he's not happy.
Can you tweet British Airways?
Okay, so I'll just read over your shoulder.
I'll read the other parts. I'm telling you, this is how I read it when I'm reading it.
Oh, you're
going to
read all of the parts?
I read all the parts.
Oh, well, fuck, I'll go home. you want your apple juice?
So, yeah. This is really well-aged apple juice.
They used to disguise it by putting it in a coffee cup.
Let's see. Scene 19. Interior Impala. Parked field day flashback.
I'm actually nervous right now.
Through one of the windows, we see Dean... out of Fed threat. Now, normally, and I don't know why, and I have no idea why, but when I'm comfortable and I'm sitting on my couch and I'm reading my script, I read all of the stage direction in an Aussie accent.
Well, we're gonna have to hear that.
Through one of the windows. Through one of the windows, we see Dean out of the Fed threat and in the cities now. Walking through a field by a forest. In the foreground, we see a cell phone on the Impala's dash. The phone rings, caller ID, it's Cass. Dean reacts. Hearing the phone, he heads over back to the car. Note, in this scene, the phone is a character. The prop is Cass. So, we can cut back to the shots of the phone as if Cass is in the car the whole time. Dean picks up the phone, puts it on speaker. Cass? More coughing from Cass. Hey man, you okay? I'm awfully confused. I'm not sure how the orange collates black in a way that's new. Okay, step away from the Netflix.
Sorry. It's okay. We've all had a binge. You find anything in the lore?
There is a creature that feeds on hearts and blood.
A werepire, you might want to say. Come on, what do you want to say?
In lore, it's referred to as the Whisper.
I have to hand it to you, it's pretty spot on. It's pretty good. I really didn't, I didn't know where you were going with that, but you nailed it. Next question, yeah.
Hi.
Hi.
Okay. You are good actors. You are good singers.
Did you just pay attention? Were you watching that last bit?
You are good dancers.
Were they all singing,
can
all
you
dancing?
Dance for us?
She thinks that she can compliment us into
dancing,
being dancing monkeys.
No, but I'll tell you what. Misha and I will write a song for you real quickly. You wanted to know about dancing?
Yeah.
What else did you want to know about?
I don't know.
Three words.
I don't know.
Influence.
Just three words. Just say three things that come
influence
to mind.
By the way, I want to go on the record as saying that I feel like Jensen is painting us into a corner here.
Tibetan throat singing.
No, we're good. This is going to be good.
Justin Belloco, fun, and love.
All right.
Okay.
So the good news is I have to put this down to play the guitar, so you're...
I stand corrected. He's painting me into a corner.
You're smart. You think on your feet. You make brilliant videos, put them on Facebook, write amazing texts and tweets and stuff. Go ahead. Spit out some lyrics, big
okay
guy.
I'll hold your mic for you.
This tall and kind of brown, she looked at me with a surly frown. She said, "Hey, Justin Bellocon." She said, "Hey, let's get our mellow on." She said, "Hey, where is the photo op? Oh yeah, I've got a guy to grow." It's Justin Bellocon. It's Justin Bellocon. We'll get our mellow on. I don't know why I picked those words.
Misha's last year at JipCon.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Have that woman removed from...
Yeah, if we could just go...
Put her on the do not return list.
That one out, that would be... Just go back and retape. We're going to go back and retape that.
Yeah.
Hi. Hi, Jensen, Misha. I hope you're having a wonderful day. And I wanted, first of all, to thank you about creating the You Are Not Alone campaign and the Supernatural Crisis Support Network. Because just the fact that you thought of us like that, it's amazingly thoughtful and awe-inspiring, and it's why I and we all love you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
In last season, Dean confessed that there's people and feelings that he would like to experience differently, or even for the first time. And this season, settling down has come up so many times. And I was just wondering if you think that Dean can ever combine a hunting and a romantic relationship in a way. And for you, Misa, if Cass could have like something in between normal and supernatural and stuff.
Are you talking about the work-home life balance and how we need to strike a better one in Supernatural?
Why not?
You're asking if Dean's ever going to have an actual relationship?
To combine, like, because I don't think he will ever get away from hunting altogether.
No. However, if there was a huntress, you guys would kill her. So, no. I'm destined to a life of solitude.
Thanks
and,
a lot.
And thank you very much.
That's true. You could have been shooting a lot of really steamy sex scenes over the years if it weren't for these fuckers.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, no. There could have been a lot of serious questions asked. And a lot of influence.
You guys have a lot of influence. You don't know how much influence you have. You just gotta tap into it.
You just found the line.
Jeremy and I kept on pushing the mic down during our panel for exactly that reason.
Thank you, Will.
Hi.
Hi. I was just wondering if, well, this question's for both of you, but if you guys could do a movie together, any movie, what movie would you
Harry Met Sally.
I knew you would say that.
I'll have what he's having.
Yes.
Hi. This question is about the supernatural.
You really were going with Harry Met Sally? This is the dance portion of the second. This is the dance segment of the Nothing like watching a couple of washed up white guys dance on a stage. That's really,
so, hey,
God.
Can I ask you a quick question?
Nope.
When did we pass our prime? Because it definitely happened at some point in the past if we're doing that now. That is what people who are trying to cling to a former success do. That is...
Where was the success? And when did it happen?
I don't
know.
And
when did it leave us?
I don't know. That's what I'm asking. Did we ever have any success, or was it all in our heads?
I think at the point where you were reading my resume and I was reading your resume.
We had a point when we were taking photos earlier where I was holding an ice cream cone that he was licking. And I thought to myself, gosh, this isn't what I imagined it was going to be like.
And then just to dab a little salt in the wound.
We had an amazing photo session, by the way.
Just dab a little salt in the wound. You know who you are, wherever you are. This lovely young woman walks up and says, I'm going to be in the middle, and you two are my bitches.
That's not the punchline.
That's not the punchline. The punchline is that me and Misha looked at each other and we went, no argument, no hesitation,
no resistance, no,
no resistance at all. Just, yeah. And then she walked away, and he looked at me and softly said to me, "That's where we are now."
What's it like to be on a long-running, successful show? Well, let me tell you.
It's when the fans really respect you, love you, adore you, admire you, and walk up to you and say, you two are the bitches in this room.
In the same photo session, we had a piece of candy, string candy, that went from... Yeah, it was like a Lady and the Tramp kind of photo, right? And so we had
you know who you are!
We had our respective ends near our mouths, and the woman standing between us said, "Eat it." And then she repeated, "Eat it." And so we did.
We often get questions. What's the weirdest thing a fan's asked to do? These are those moments. Now, I will say that most of that photo session, I would say 99% of that photo session, very enjoyable. You people are fucking awesome. However, playing Lady and the Tramp and acting like bitches, that's not on the resumes we read years ago.
No. We have to add that now to our resumes.
So now we get to add that into our special, what is it? Special skills. Yeah. Special skills. Bitches. Let's take another question. You're wasting so much time.
I don't think that she ever even, she just started saying something and we went on a
stop. Hi.
Yes.
Hi, again.
Hi.
When I heard about the Supernatural Crisis Support Network, it got me from the first moment, and I mean, it's such a beautiful way to direct the energy of all those people to help each other. And I know that at the point last month, 9,000 people had assigned to it to help other people. And I wanted to ask, how did you come up with this beautiful idea? And thank you very much again.
We were all flying back from a convention one night, and I don't remember where the convention was, but it was somewhere in the U.S. It was one of the creation conventions, and we were talking about... it had been... We, at every convention, I think it's fair to say, at every convention, people come up to us and tell us stories about traumatic experiences that they've had in their life, or
very difficult periods that they have struggled through, and how either the show or our characters or the community that has coalesced around the show have really helped them in some way. We hear stories about, people say very often to us things like, I feel like I wouldn't be here if it weren't for, the show and you guys. And it sometimes gets incredibly emotional. I